This week, women on the board, why there aren't enough of them. And our guest is Professor Keith Cuthbertson. Professor, just how bad is the current situation?
Well, at the moment, there's about 12% of women on FTSE 100 boards. And this rise has been very, very slow over the last 5 years. And of course, women are underrepresented elsewhere in the percentage of High Court judges, percentage of Vice Chancellors. And I believe there's one woman Supreme Court judge as well. So although women have made many advances, it seems to me they've got a long way to go, and they've got a long way to go as far as boards are concerned as well.
Now, I'm treading on dangerous, politically incorrect territory here, but there will be some men watching this podcast who will say, well, why does this matter?
Well, I think the main reason is that the men, for whatever, let's say, rational reasons, are missing, or potentially missing, just a very large talent pool here. After all, you know, Margaret Thatcher was said to be good at what she does. Lady Gaga was said to be good at what she does. And I expect most women have got the X factor as far as boards are concerned. So we want to give them a chance, really. And I don't think the latest report is really giving them enough of a chance.
Yes, this is the report by Lord Davies. You've described this as a nudge to industry, but you think it should go further?
Yes, I think really the men need to kick up the backside rather than a nudge.
Strong words.
Because, well, if you look around the world, whenever there's been nudges elsewhere in other countries to try and get more women on the boards, it hasn't really worked. Even in Norway, where you'd think intrinsically, you know, the men have a favourable view of the women, they started off with a nudge, but then around 2006, they had to give the men a kick up the backside by actually introducing quotas. As soon as the quotas were introduced, with penalties as well, if you didn't achieve the quotas, then by God, did the men move pretty fast.
So this is a kick with steel-capped boots?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
So you mentioned Norway. Are there other countries that maybe we can learn from?
Well, Finland also have quotas, and Iceland introduced the quotas after the banking crash. Because you may have noticed that worldwide, the banking crash, at least just on pure statistical observation, it was the men that were at the top when we had the massive banking crisis. And of course, Iceland had perhaps the biggest one. And now they've introduced quotas, and of course, some of those women will now be running what is essentially left of the Icelandic banks.
But you're saying that actually if women are at the top, maybe something like that might not happen in the future because of the difference in attitude of the sexes?
Yes, I think it's a difference in attitude. That's very difficult to sort of measure, of course. And we don't have a real, you know, test which ultimately does separate out how much difference women will make. I mean, ideally what we'd like to do is to get an all-male board and an all-female board, then have a set of candidates, yeah, male and female, which we know are equally as good, and then see if 50% of the board, which are males, they appoint 50% women, 50% men, and what the female board does. Now, we don't have an acid test like that, but we have lots of observations on women on boards throughout the United States, throughout Norway and other countries. And what we find is that the larger the proportion of women on boards, the performance of the firm is no worse in those firms and is sometimes actually better.
Last question. Of course, the argument against having a quota system is that it becomes tokenism, that women are only given the job because the company has to tick a box.
Well, first of all, you need the quotas because of the catch-22 situation. If the woman goes in front of the all-male board and says, I'd like to be on your board, please, the board says, oh, well, you're very, very good, but one thing, you have no board experience, so we can't appoint you. If that happens everywhere, and I think it probably does, given the old boy network that works in terms of these boards, then of course you're never going to get there unless you have something like quotas.
Professor Keith Cuthbertson, thank you very much.
Thank you.